Safra. So happy to see you this Sunday again. May God bless you. May God bless your family, bless your life, and be with you and protect you all the days of your life. We thank Him always because He's the only one who can protect us and save us. Actually, when we always mention these wishes to all of you, sometimes it became just a routine. Like Abuna, he said, God bless you, be with you, and protect you, and all this. But we don't realize how important is this prayer that we ask our Heavenly Father for until for God, but when we go through hard time. Last week, we all hear about the bus, one of the Paramus school that had an accident. And maybe two people, I believe, they did because of the accident. And unfortunately, we had two students from our community, but fortunately that nothing happened to them. So that's why we need always to ask our Heavenly Father for protection, for peace, for reconciliation between each other. And one of them, where is John? One of the students who was in the bus, and thank God I was surprised to see him on the altar. So I want to thank God for him. I think God protect him. This is John, his deacon. So thank God for you. John is one of the Sunday school teachers. He born here, and he been baptized in this church, and he's in Sunday school and Aramaic school, and now he is also altar boy, Shamosho. So may God bless him, and bless, of course, his family. And I say that to encourage you. When we entrust our children in the hand of the Almighty One, He is the only one can protect our children when we as a parents, we are not there for them. I know and I believe how much you have love for your children, but you cannot be there for them 24/7. But you can put them in the hand of the one who can be with them 24/7, and He protect them day and night, while we are asleep and while we are awake. So I just called him actually to thank God. I believe it's a miracle, because if you see the news and if you see the bus, how miserable the accident was, we would recognize how important to see our children now coming back safe. So may God bless you and be with you and protect your children and protect you, protect your family, protect your life always. Today, as the Bible, at the beginning of the liturgy, I was reading, we celebrate a very important feast we call Ascension to Heaven, as it's mentioned here on the altar, Ascension to our Lord to Heaven. We know that one day God, out of His love, when He promised long time ago, after our father Adam and our mother Eve, they fell in the sin and they broke the commandment of God. Later on, God, out of His law, He promised Eve, when He was talking to her, and this is very early in the Bible, when He said, from your seed will come the one, he will smash the head of the serpent. And that promise, God kept it until one day He became a man, the second person in the Holy Trinity, which is Jesus Christ. And later on, He was on the cross, He died and raised. And after 40 days, this is what we celebrating today, we call it Ascension to Heaven. When Jesus ascended to heaven, when Jesus was taken up to the heaven, because actually He has to fulfill all the prophecies and all the story of the salvation in Him. So He had to fulfill it and it came to the point that he has to go back to heaven. Even Jesus, he became man like us. He took flesh and he was among us, walking, eating. And actually the Bible says he was like us in everything except the sin. He's the only one, is the perfect one. He's without sin, without any blemish, without anything. So this absolute and this perfect God, after he raised, he was with his disciples for 40 days. The Bible says that he was teaching them the secret of the kingdom, which means he was explaining to them, because the first 3 years he was with them, they thought he is maybe prophet. Like one time he asked, "Who am I?" He was asking his disciples. They say Elijah, Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. So they were thinking that he is one of the prophets, or he is one of the leader for his people. But they didn't recognize that he is the incarnate God. So that's why after 40 days, he was teaching them and tell them and explaining to them everything. And we can read this very obvious in the book of Acts. And then one time, he took them, took his disciples, he took them to the top of the mountain of Olives. Like the Bible says, it was like a seventh journey away from Jerusalem. And then he blessed them. That's why at the beginning of every time I begin any speech, I have to ask our Heavenly Father to bless us. This is what he said. Before he left, he blessed his disciples. And these blessings, actually, it's extending until now. Every time we pray, we believe he is with us, and he do the same thing, because he lay his hands and bless his disciples. So if we believe in his presence amongst us, we know that he's blessing us as well. And then the Bible says he was taken up to heaven, and the disciples, they were looking up to him. Of course, they know that he is going and they will miss him. So that's why they were looking up. And then all of a sudden, two angels with white clothes, they came and they told them, "Do not worry. The way that you see this man, he was going up to heaven, he will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven." So the same way that you see him is going up, you will see him coming back. That's why in our churches, actually this is very important, because some people they ask, why our churches, Abuna, is not facing the people during the liturgy, is giving, I give you my back almost all the liturgy. Why Abuna is not looking to us? Our Eastern theology or Orthodox theology, that you with me, we all look to the East. And we like saying in our heart, "Lord, we are waiting for you." So we all look to you. Of course we look to the East because the sun, which is refers to the light, and Jesus, he said, "I am the light of the world." So that's why you and myself, we always during the prayer, we look to the East, kind of we asking our Savior, the way he went to heaven, we are now looking for your second coming. We are waiting for your second coming. And when we talk actually about the ascension to heaven, since ascension of our Lord to heaven, a lot of time, we ask ourselves, how can we apply, how can we live this feast as a Christian? We know Jesus, he went up to heaven. But me as a Christian today, how can I live the spiritual benefit of this feast? Actually, we know that Jesus, he did not need to be glorified because he is God. He has the angels that actually, they glorify him 24/7. But he did this to tell us the way that I am going up to heaven, so everyone who believes in me, one day he will also go back to heaven. So what Jesus actually did in this feast, it was just an example to everyone. He wants also to go to heaven. So that's why the angels, they told, the way you see him going back up. So everyone, he wants to go up to spend his eternity with him, to spend his eternity in heaven. He need actually to believe him, and the way he went up, we also, we will go up. So actually, if we want to know the significance and the importance of this occasion, we have to understand very important couple things. Number one, when Jesus was taken up to heaven, that was actually a sign that his earthly mission was done. He has nothing to do anymore as an incarnate person in the Holy Trinity, which means what he came for, he had done it. He came to put his life in order of everyone who believes in him, he will also be saved and will go to heaven. So that's why celebrating the Feast of Ascension is very important to remember that the salvation works had been done when Jesus went to heaven. Number two, if we want to actually understand the importance of this feast, we have to understand not only Jesus, he had done his mission, earthly mission, but this mission actually had been accomplished successfully. Which means what he came for, he done it right. And we remember the last sentence Jesus mentioned on the cross, when he was on the cross. Do you remember what was the last sentence? He said, it's finished, it's accomplished. Which means, I came to save you, and it's accomplished, this mission. So not only Jesus, when he was going up to heaven, that his earthly actually work or mission was, ministry was done, but also he done it successfully. And this actually has a strong call to everyone. If you wanna have the eternal life, you have to go to him. And this is the third actually significant point that I wanna raise up. Because Jesus, before he left, he was being taken up to heaven, he promised his disciples something very important. He said, remain in Jerusalem, stay in Jerusalem, until you will receive the Holy Spirit, the power from above. They believed him because everything he had said, he done it right. So they went back to Jerusalem, and the Bible said they were praying every day in the upper room in Zion, upper room of Zion. And then after 10 days from the ascension to heaven, he sent his Holy Spirit. So why this is important in our life? We have to understand something very important. Number one, when Adam and Eve, they fell into sin, actually, they did this sin against God the Father. Of course, the Father and the Son, the Holy Spirit, they are one in nature, in divine, in divinity. But when they actually broke the law, they broke the law against God the Father. And since then, the Father, he was, I can say, angry. Angry on the whole human race. But out of his love, he decided to send the second person, which is Jesus Christ in the Trinity. And also he accomplished his mission, his ministry. And before he left, he promised that he will send the Holy Spirit. Now the actually job of the Holy Spirit is to take all of us and to repent and to believe in Jesus Christ, whom he died on the cross, we will be able to please God the Father. So actually, to wait for the Holy Spirit, it was very important. Without the Holy Spirit, we cannot repent. We cannot believe. We cannot say that Jesus is God without the power of the Holy Spirit. So that's why it was very important for us to receive the Holy Spirit. Because without the Holy Spirit, we cannot believe in Jesus. We cannot believe in God. So the job of the Holy Spirit was very essential in this point. That's why Jesus, when he said, remain in Jerusalem, stay in Jerusalem, until I will send you the power from above. This power, what it does, which is the Holy Spirit, it actually leads us to Jesus. And if we believe in him, what he had done on the cross, we will be able to please God the Father. That's why the Holy Trinity, Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, they complete each other. We cannot believe in Jesus without the power of the Holy Spirit. And if we believe in Jesus, we will be able to please God the Father. But I want to end up with a very important statement Jesus said on book of John chapter 14. One day he said, in my Father's house are many dwelling places. In other words, he said, in my Father's house there is a lot of mansions. But let me tell you something. This is what Jesus is saying. He said, I will go up, for I go to prepare a place for you. I always, when I read these verses, I meditate like this. I say, imagine if I will give to one of the best engineers in this world, I will give him unlimited amount of money, telling him, take as much as you want time, but I want you to build for me the best mansions ever. Maybe in 10 years, 15 years, he will come to me, giving me the key, telling me go, and you will see the best mansion or maybe place ever. A lot of money, a lot of time, a lot of experience will end up with the best place ever. But now let's apply this on what Jesus was telling us. He went to heaven 2,000 almost years ago. And he is the one, he is the rich in everything. And since then until now, he is preparing a place for all those who believe in him. So can you imagine how this place will look like? Never ever we can imagine how this place is beautiful. But let me tell you something. Saint Paul one time, he went up to heaven and he came back. And he said what actually the eyes cannot be seen and the ear cannot be actually heard, what actually God prepared for those who believe in him. So we have to understand the place that Jesus went up to prepare for us is the eternal life for all those who believe in him. So that's why when he was taken up to heaven, he was doing this to tell you that I want to give you the crown of the glory if you believe in me, the way I was glorified and was taken up to heaven. I will take you with me if you do believe in me. May God bless you, dear brothers and sisters. And we need to have strong faith as long as we are alive. We have to take an opportunity, the call of the Holy Spirit, who is calling us to repent and to open our heart and to have full faith on Jesus Christ. If we do so, we will actually be also taken up to heaven on the cloud the way was Jesus taken up to heaven. May God bless you, and I pray that one day all of us, we can go up with him and he will come and tell us, come inheritance the kingdom of God. May God bless all of you and protect you in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. After